Step one of the LevelSmart installation process is going to be install the valve. In this case, we installed the valve into a designated fill line near the equipment here. And so all we're going to do is we're simply going to install the valve right in line with that. In some cases, it might be installed from a water source teed into the return line, which I'll show an example of in the corner here. All right, so now that we completed step one and we have our valve installed here, the second step is going to be install and mount the valve controller. So we're using the transformer. We have it mounted right here on the wall. We installed the valve controller here using the mounting screws that came in the accessory kit. We have a 3-pin plug for the transformer, so we're just going to plug it into our nearby power supply. Once you do that, you'll get 3 scrolling lights on the controller. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take the relay wire here with the two open ends, and we're going to connect it to our valve here. And it doesn't matter if it's black on red or red on red. It's all the same stuff. So we're just going to use the wire nuts that came in the kit and get these all connected here. All right, so now we're all connected. We have our valve connected to our controller. Controller is scrolling. We're connected to power. Power's right here. And we're going to go on to step 3. All right, so now that we got step 2 completed, we have the controller mounted. It's flashing all 3 lights. The power supply is plugged in and installed to power. What we're going to do is we're going to install and connect all antenna connections here. So the kit comes at 25 feet of antenna extension here. In this case, as you can see, the pool is right behind this wall here. It's super close by. So we're just going to go directly to the antenna tip, as you can see here. So we're simply just going to attach it here. When you're doing this, make sure that these are all tight. We want to make sure that the connections are solid here. It does not require line of sight. So this antenna will go around corners. It will go through walls. In this case, it's facing this way, even though the pool is this way. It's going to be just fine in this situation. If you do have a more difficult situation, you do want to use the antenna extension, put it up higher, maybe put it in the rafters, whatever it takes to make it adapt to your situation. But it is a powerful radio platform. And so now that we have this installed, we can move on to our next step. All right, so now that we got step 3 complete, we have the antenna tip mounted successfully. We are now going to make sure that the controller and the sensor at the pool communicate. And so right now we have the controller, it is in pairing mode. We know it's in pairing mode because the lights are scrolling from the bottom to the top on the controller here. And so it's looking for a sensor to pair with. So now we're gonna go to the pool and we're gonna make sure that the sensor will communicate to the controller in the position that it's gonna live in. All right, so now that we got the controller in pairing mode, the 3 lights are flashing from the bottom to the top. We have come to the pool and we've decided that this skimmer is the best place to install it. When we install it on this entryway to the skimmer, it's hidden, it's out of sight. And so we've decided that this is where we want to install the sensor. We want to make sure that they're going to communicate successfully with each other from the controller to the sensor. And so we're going to use the magnet, place it on the sensor here for 5 seconds, and we're going to remove it. We're going to get 3 green flashes out of the light here, and we're simply just going to set it here and let it go through the 2.5-minute pairing process so that we know that it's gonna pair successfully and we're safe to adhere it to the water line in the skimmer entryway. So we got the 3 green flashes. Now we're gonna set it down. We're gonna leave it here and we're gonna go to the controller and watch it go through the pairing process. So now it just got wind. It's gonna do 30 flashes, 1 second apart. After the first 30 flashes, it'll start flashing every 4 seconds, and that's gonna be the calibration back end of the process. Once we have that, we should have a solid green sensor light. All right, 2.5 minutes has gone by and we have a solid green sensor light here indicating that the sensor and the controller have paired successfully. All right, so now that we've kneaded the epoxy and put it on the back of the sensor here, we're just firmly holding it in place in the desired location that we want it to be installed. Just make sure, and you want to make note of what I've just explained in regards to your desired water level in the sensing area on the sensor. Just make sure and double check that's within reasonable range and just hold it for 90 seconds. Make sure we have a solid bond and we will be good to go. All right, so now that we've installed the sensor, it's adhered to the entryway of the skimmer here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take the magnet, we're gonna bring the water level up to our desired level, which in this case is a little lower on the sensor. And we're actually going to put the magnet on the sensor here, right on the logo. Just hold count to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take it off. You're gonna get 3 green flashes out of that sensor. Now, if we go back to the controller, the sensor light on the controller will be flashing, indicating it's calibrating to the new level. All right, so the sensor light has stopped flashing now. We're back to a solid green sensor light. That means everything is good. We're repaired successfully, and that we have a set level that the LevelSmart will know it has to maintain. All right, so now that we got the controller and the sensor calibrated with a set water level, now we wanna go over to the valve. A couple things I wanna go over here is we have a flow control knob here on the valve. So if you're on a spa, a smaller pond, a smaller water feature, you wanna turn this knob down. So we wanna go clockwise and tighten it about maybe halfway down. And that's gonna allow it to put less water in on each fill because the fill period is 7 minutes. So whenever the sensor does call for water, it will fill for 7 minutes. And after 7 minutes, it will shut off. And so on a smaller body of water, we wanna limit the amount of water going into that body of water. So we're going to actually make sure we make use of the flow control knob. The second thing about the valve that we need to go over is just you always need to make sure that this solenoid knob is in the off position. You'll see it on here. It's labeled on and off. It's clockwise. You want it always down to the right and make sure it's in the off position so that the LevelSmart can turn it on and turn it off. If it's in the on position, you're at risk of overfilling because it's in manual mode and water will continue to pass through the valve. So very important. And the third thing is you just want to make sure that the arrow on the valve body is going the same way as the water in the pipe. And just make sure that the valve's not installed backwards. All right, so now that we've gone over our valve, we've dialed in the flow control knob, we've made sure that the solenoid knob is in the off position. We're gonna take the magnet and we're actually gonna put it on the controller. If you put it too high, you won't get the red alarm light. So you always wanna scoot it down until you get your red alarm light, which you got, count to two, one, two, take it off, and you have your action light. Action means there's power being supplied to the valve. The valve is now on for 5 seconds and will shut off after 5 seconds. This confirms that the wire nuts are tight, the connections are solid, and that your valve will turn on when power is supplied to it to maintain the level of your pool.